Hello everyone. In last class, we have seen that the formation of the rainbows. We have two types of rainbows, primary rainbow and secondary rainbow. And how is the rainbow formed? What is the condition for the formation of the rainbow? These are things we have discussed in detail in last class. Then let me go forward for the next topic that whenever, so everybody would be experienced this one, that in your childhood, whenever you go to a fair, you will buy it and play with that one. Or in so many films, you would watch it, that for a heroine engagement, the hero will destroy that one and will stop to that engagement by burning a paper within that ceremony. That is what the friends of the hero, they will do something with one instrument or one lens. I think you get the point now. Yes. So whenever you go to repair your watch, there the watch repair, to observe the parts of the watch, they use that lens. And not only that, whenever you go to biology or zoology, that is what biology, zoology or botany, when you go to the labs, in first few already you have experienced that to observe the slides, you use one instrument. That is what these will be used in the camera constructions. So these things we have to learn about the which will be causes to the burning a paper, which will be required to burn a paper without have any flame. Is it possible to burn a paper without having a flame? Is it? Yes. How is it possible? With what we can do this thing? Just think it. That is what in previous classes you have studied about the lenses, and then you have studied about two types of lenses, convex lens and concave lens. And not only the formation of the images, and also you draw the ray diagrams for those lenses for different portions of the object, and you trace the image of the object to correspond to the position of the object by using such type of the lenses, whether is it concave or convex lens. And when you studied about the convex lens, particularly except one portion of the object, you will get all the image formed by the lens is real and inward. But whenever the object is in between optical center and focus point, then the image formed is erect, magnified, and it is watchful. I think you are clear now. Then what do you call this position of the lens? Particularly, we give the name for this type of the lens as microscope. That is what, whenever we express microscope, we will think something, it is a big. But when you think, when you discuss with the lens, it is, you will come to know that very easily. Let me discuss about the, some of the optical instruments which will be useful in our life and in our laboratories. Those are called optical instruments. Optical instruments. Yes, we have to call it as optical instruments, not an electrical instrument. Electrical instrument represents it based on the electrical properties and current. When it passes, then it operates. But optical instruments means which is based on the light. whenever it makes to visible, which causes to visible the object? Light causes to visible the. What type of the light? What do you mean by the light? Just we know in previous classes that light is nothing but the visible region which causes to visible. Then violet to the red, which is having 4000 angstrom to the 8000 angstrom range of the wavelengths of the electromagnetic wave is nothing but the light. So let me discuss that if you want to view an object which is comfortable to view an object, I have taken this object. If I place whenever it is very far from me, very far from you, so that what would be the angle subtended by the eye? It is very less the angle subtended by the eye. But if I brought nearer to the eye, so you can observe that one, the angle subtended is very large and also your eye will get strained. Then is it comfortable to view an object very nearer to or very closer to your eye? Yes, it's not comfortable to view an object very closer to the eye. But I want to do that one very closer and bigger. Then how is it possible? Can you make it is possible? Yes, you can make it possible by using simple microscope. What do you mean by this simple microscope? Simple microscope is nothing but a convex lens. Yes, when we tell simple microscope, we think that it is a one big instrument, maybe like, or whenever you know that convex lens, yes, it is very simple thing. Now then, what do you mean by the simple microscope? Let me discuss about the simple microscope. Simple microscope is a convergent lens of short focal. For what purpose we use these microscopes? Microscope or telescope, these all things are optical instruments. In your childhoods, whenever you go to fair, I think you would buy this simple microscope and you played with that simple microscope. You use it to view the objects in for bigger images, and not only that, to burn a paper, or even I think we have buy these binoculars. These all are nothing but these optical instruments. Just I have started with the lens, convex lens. Yes, simple microscope is nothing but a convergent lens. I am not telling that the convex lens. Is it because of converging lens? Converging lens of short focal length. Short focal length. Converging lens of short focal length. Converging lens of short focal length is called simple microscope. Does it call always as simple microscope? For all positions of the object, does it act as a simple microscope? No. But whenever the position of the object is very close to this lens, then only you will get the magnified and erected virtual image. So that before we discuss about the simple microscope, as we have started already with the size of the image, that is what the angular size of the object, which is comfortable to view. Just you think over it. An object very close to your eye, or it is which is at a far distance, which is comfortable to your eye. Yes, of course, it is very comfortable to view an objects which are at a far distances. We can enjoy which are at far distance. But if it is very close to your eye, it is not comfortable for your eye. Your eye gets strained. Now our purpose is to observe the size of the object bigger than that of the actual size. And when you kept very close to your eye, so let me take an example here. I have taken here this object, and this is not now easy. Now it is very comfortable for my view. But whenever I brought close to my eye, and my eye is getting strained because the size of the angular size of the object is more. Still it is more, and now it is very blurred. Very blurred. That means, can we see this image bigger or nearer to our eye by using any other instrument? Any instrument. That is what simple. Now look at this one. I have taken. This is a piece of object, but I observe with this my eye. Now it is very bigger, and the image is closer to my portion of the eye. And you will see this image of these letters. You will see this image of the letters. When I keep this very close to these letters, it would appear as magnified. And you can observe here, this is what a convex lens of short focal length. And let me touch this one. When I touch, this edges are thin, and at this middle it is having more thickness. At periphery thin, and at edge, at middle it is having more thickness. See that. Less focal length means the lens which is having less focal length. That means, what is the focal length of the lens? We can estimate even by touching the lens. Based on thickness of, we can estimate the focal length of the lens. More is the thickness, less is the focal length. Less is the thickness, more is the focal length. So that what you can observe here, this is having more thickness, so that the focal length of this lens would be very small. That's what, when I wrote here, converging lens of short focal length will be act as a simple microscope. This is the lens. Let me draw it. You know already the formation of images by the convex lenses. Let me take a convex lens. Already you know that it is a converging lens. It converges the light rays which are falling on the aperture of the lens. And this is what the optical center of the lens. And when you draw, we have two focus points here, F1, 2F1, here F2 and 2F2. Then the line joining the centers of curvature of the lens is principal axis. Let you remember the position of the object for which we will get the erect and magnified image. Yes, we know that. When the position of the object is in between optical center and focus, Now, how to draw the diagram for the formation of images by the lenses, a ray which is parallel to the principal axis. It refracts through the second focus, and ray which is passing through the optical center, it is not DVD. These two refracted rays are not intersecting, so that we have to produce these refracted rays are back. Then whenever you produce these refracted rays are back, this is the position of, if we have taken, it is AB, and then this is the point corresponding to B dash, and now only on this one A dash, B dash. It's nothing but the image of this object with respect to object, the image of this object here. That means you get here that when the object is in between optical center and focus, then the image will be formed on the same side of the object, which is magnified, erect, and but we cannot catch it on the screen, so that we call it a workshop. Microscope. Why do we call it a microscope? Because it gives the image of the small particles as a bigger background size, or dust particles. The size is very big. How much it can be means the magnification of the simple microscope is around less than or equal to 9. Around less than or equal to 9. Okay. Now we have observed this object AB by using this microscope. By using this microscope. Whenever your position of the object is in the extreme reflected rays, in between the extreme refracted rays, then you will see this object, image of that object. This is the case by using microscope we have observed this. Now if u is the distance of the object from the lens, and this is what image distance, we know h dash is the size of the image, and h is the size of the object, then what would be the angle subtended by the image by using instrument, which is microscope, angle subtended by the image. Let me take here beta. Beta, what you can write here, tan beta is equal to opposite by adjacent. That means size of the image by size of the object, or size of the object by size of the distance of the object, and whereas size of the image by distance of the image. So that what you can read here, tan beta, which is nothing but h by u. Even you can write h dash by e, but let me write here h by u. Now here, now we have not used this microscope. When we have used this microscope, you can keep the image of this object can be observed very clear and magnified. But without using microscope, is it possible to observe the view this object very near to the eye? Yes, it's not possible. That means what is the least distance of the clearest vision? That what we call is a near point. Least distance of distinct vision, the minimum distance at which the object can be observed clearly, that is what we call the least distance of distinct vision, or near point of the eye. Now for a normal eye means what? The eye which is not having any defect in formation of the images. So for a normal eye, the image, the same object you have taken, A and B, it would sustain an angle. What would be the angle sustained by this one? D. What do you call this? D. D is nothing but what? Near point. D is near point. Near point. But remember, for small angles, tan beta can be written as beta. For small angles, tan theta is equal to theta, sin theta is equal to theta. So what we can write here, tan theta is equal to beta, which is equal to h by u. Or even you can write h dash by v, and h dash by h is equal to v by u. Similarly, if the angle subtended by the eye, the angle subtended by the object at the eye, naked eye, without having any instrument, that is what alpha. So what you can write here? The same object is in the same size. Then what you get here? Tan alpha, which is equal to h by d. D represents what? Near point. For normal eye, the near point value is 25 cm. 25 cm. For defected eye, that is depending upon where is it short sightedness or long sightedness, depending upon that, the near point will be changes again. So here we are not discussing about the defects of the eye, because that topic is removed from this latest syllabus, so that we are not going to discuss about the defects of the eye. That's what. Now, for this simple microscope, we need to find the magnifying power of this simple microscope. Magnifying power. What do you mean by the magnifying power? You know already the linear magnification. Linear magnification is nothing but the ratio of the size of the image to the size of the object, length of the image to the length of the object. But here, angular magnification. Angular magnification is nothing but the angle subtended by the image at the eye by using instrument. And this is what beta. Beta, and you can observe by using instrument, the angle subtended by the object and angle subtended by the image remains same. That is what the angular size of the image and angular size of the object is remains same when we have used this instrument. Then angular magnification or magnifying power, angular magnification. M is equal to visual angle subtended by the image to the visual angle subtended by the object. That is what here magnification, angular magnification or magnifying power of the simple microscope is. Writing here visual angle, visual angle at eye by the instrument, that is what here visual angle at eye by the instrument for what may visual angle of image to the visual angle of object, angle of object with naked eye, without having any instrument, with naked eye. Now, second idea which is nothing but we can observe here with image beta we have taken with object with naked eye, half we have taken. So let me write here magnifying power is equal to beta by alpha, angular magnifying power, angular magnification. That is equal to beta is what you know here, beta h by u by alpha is nothing but h by d. Let me write here h by u by h by d. That is equal to magnifying power d by u is the magnifying power of the simple microscope. D by u, wait, what is the near point? U represents what? Object distance. Object distance. Let me find what would be the magnifying power of the simple microscope when you get the image at a near point, that means by using that one, when you kept the object very near to that one, but object is nearer, but where do you get image? to get near point. Near point means 25 centimeter. Then in that case, what would be the angular magnification? And not only that, what would be the magnifying power of the simple microscope when you get the image at infinity at f of? Let me try to explain. When image for a near point an image formed at near point. You know very well, image formed at near point, so that what would the image distance? Infinity. Then image distance is equal to what? V is equal to infinity. Where do you get the object? Generally you know that whenever the object is at a length which is equal to the focal length, then the image is formed at infinity by using length formula, thin length formula, thin length formula, 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by thin length formula. Lens maker's formula, 1 by F is equal to N minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R. This is what? The formula first thin lens of a optical lenses. So this is 1 by V minus 1 by U. Let me substitute here, 1 by infinity minus 1 by U is nothing but by using sign convention U will be negative whenever it is taken, minus U is equal to 1 by U. Therefore, what you get here? U is equal to F. Now tell me, what is your magnifying power? Magnifying power M is equal to D by U. That is equal to M is equal to D by U is nothing but what? F. This is what, when image is formed at near point, can you draw the diagram for this? Yes. Here, I have taken a convex lens of short focal length, and here we have F. Object is taken at focus. Then the image is formed at these two rays are parallel. That means when you extend back, the image will be formed at infinity. Image formed at infinity. Here infinity. So object is at focal length. Then the image object is at infinity. Image forms at focus. Our object is at focus. Image is formed at infinity. So this is what. Now to get the image at the near point, image at near point means what? Compulsory the position of the object is in between optical center and the focus point. That's what, let me take here. When image formed at near point, near point, what is magnifying power of the simple microscope? We need to find that one. Near point, then what would be the V value? D, which is nothing but minus T. Then V is equal to what you know? Minus T. Therefore, 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. That is equal to 1 by V minus D minus 1 by minus U is equal to 1 by F. Then what is here? Minus 1 by D, minus 1 minus plus 1 by U. 1 by U is equal to 1 by D plus 1 by F. Is it? So let me find. Magnifying power for near point. That is equal to M is equal to already we know D by U, then D into 1 by U. 1 by U is nothing but 1 by D minus 1 by F. Then 1 by D, sorry, here plus 1 by F will get. Yes, 1 by D plus 1 by F. 1 by d plus 1 by d. That is equal to 1 plus d by n is the magnified power of the simple matrix. Now, can you observe in what case is the magnifying power of the simple microscope is maximum? For near point 1 plus d by f, for infinity, for far point d by f. So definitely for when the image formed at near point, the magnifying power of the lens is maximum. That is what, for example, if focal length of the lens is given, focal length of convex lens is given 5 cm, then what will be the magnifying power of the lens when the image formed at infinity? At near point, what is formula? M is equal to 1 plus V by F. But we know near point is what? 25 cm is equal to 1 plus 25 by focal length of the lens is what? 5 is equal to what? 6. No unit, 6. That represents the angular size of the image is 6 times the angular size of the object. Whereas, when it is formed at far point, at infinity, magnifying power is equal to d by f, that is equal to 25 by 5, which is equal to 5. So 1 less than the area. This is what, but I have not satisfied with this magnification, then what I have to do? What we have to do? Then instead of using this simple microscope, that means by you, instead of using a single lens, we use two lenses. Use two lenses or three lenses. That is what, you know, we can use compound microscope. That means if we, when we have use of two lenses, one lens compounds the effect of the another. For that purpose, we have used two lenses, and the lens which is the microscope which is having two lenses is called compound microscope. Compound microscope. Compound microscope. And this microscope is having very importance of magnification, because it gives more magnification when you compare to the simple microscope. And in compound microscope, how many lenses we are using? Here we have used two lenses. One is convex lens of short focal length, and one more is also the convex lens only, but large focal length. And by using this simple compound microscope, we get the magnification more than the 100 also. That means, if it is size of this is 100 degrees, or if you want to view the 1 degree angular size, it would become 100 degrees. 100 degrees. Is it? For that purpose, we have here two lenses. Two lenses. One is the lens which is close to the object, called object 2. One is object 2, called close to the object. And which focus the object is called object 2 lens. And another one which is eyepiece and near to eye. Now, two lenses having focal length, object 2 is having less focal length and eyepiece having more focal length. That's what focal length of object 2 is taken as F0 for of object 2. F0. Whereas focal length of eyepiece or eyelens is FE. And remember that one which is close to the object. That means we have to take the object is object size of very small. That means what? The focal length, focus point should be very less. That's what? Focal length of the object is less than focal length of the eyelens. And for this one, let us try to find the magnifying power of the compound microscope. Whenever we have taken for compound microscope, we have two lenses. One is, what do we call this? Object 2, having focal length F0, which is called object 2. Object 2. And another one, this is what? Optical center of the object 2. And here we have focus point. Here also the focus point, focal length of the object 2. Now the distance from the optical center to the focus point is called what? Focal length. Now we take the object, for compound microscope. The position of the object in front of the object 2 is in between 2F and F1. We have one under F1. Let me take here an object. Now, this object should get magnified. The image of this object should get as magnified. Now, let me take here what happens when you take a light ray which is parallel to the principal axis. It passes through the focus point. Focus point and one more ray which is passing through the optical center would not deviate. Now these two rays are intersecting at this point, then this is the corresponding image of this object, AB. Now corresponding B, this is what? B dash, and this is what? A dash. Okay. Now we have taken this is what object 2, and where we should get eyelens. Short focal length, and it is what? Large focal length. For this eyelens, look at this. The distance of the object from this object is called object distance, and the distance of the image from the optical center is called image distance. So that you can observe here what is the distance V0. And you can see here, this is the number F0. From here, here it is F0. Is the size of the AB, size of the object, original object, H. Now, A dash, B dash, image of the object 2, image of object 2, image of the object 2. So, which is called? Which is nothing but object 2 of the eyelens. This will be acted as object for the eyelens. Object of eyelens. H1. Let me take this H1. Now, where do we get the final image? If you want, that means we have to adjust the position of the eyelenses and the object is depending upon where we get the image, where we want to get the image. One more light ray, if it is an optical center, and if you are taking this is nearer to the FE, this is what? FE. It is an FE. Is at FE, when the object is at E, where the getting is, this will be act as object 2. This will be act as object for eye lens, and this object is at focus point, then we get the image at infinity. Image at infinity. Let us take one light ray, which is FE here, and one more parallel to the axis, and then we can observe here, which is parallel to the axis, passes through the focus point, which is passing through the optical center, it does not get deviated. Then where do you get the image? Final image? Yeah, infinity. At infinity. Now you can observe here, from here the image is nothing but F naught, from here the image is nothing but FE. And from the definition of the tube length of, what is the length of the microscope? You can observe that almost this F naught is very less, so that FE can be V naught, from here to here V naught. And this position of the object from eye lens is nothing but UE. UE represents what? Object of the eye lens. Now, we have used two lenses here. When we have used two lenses, or three lenses, or four lenses, resultant magnification is the product of the all the magnification of the lenses. Product of each magnification of the lens. Then we can write here total magnification is equal to magnification of the object into magnification of the eye lens. Let me write the terms here. V naught is for image of the object. V naught is the object of the eye lens, which is UE. That will be act as image of the object, and it will be act as the object of eye lens. Then UE represents object distance of eye lens. V naught is what? Image of object 2. Image of object 2. We know now the magnification is nothing but the ratio of the distance of the image to the distance of the object. Then let me write here V naught by U naught into ME for a eye lens, which is nothing but D by UE. From where we have derived this expression from the simple microscope, V naught by U naught into D by UE. But even you can write V naught by U naught as L by F naught, because magnification of the object is nothing but, if you have taken, this is the alpha and this is also the same angle. What do you mean by the magnification? The ratio of the size of the image to the size of the object. And one important point we need to remember here, cube length is nothing but the distance from the focus point of object to the focus point of the eye lens, the distance between second focus of the object to the first focus of the eye lens is called cube length. Distance between second focus of object 2 to the first focus of eye lens, which is L, length of the microscope. Can you tell here what is the length of the microscope? Whenever you get the image at infinity, what is UE? UE is nothing but what? F naught. FE. And what again here? V naught plus FE. Now, for this one, when image at infinity, reagent utility. So what you get here, L is equal to V naught plus UE, which is nothing but V naught plus FE. V naught plus FE. Then what you can write here, magnification is equal to V naught by U naught into D by FE. D by FE. So already you know, even you can get this directly. When the position of the object is at focus point, image will be created at infinity, so that here UE is nothing but FE. That's what we have written here. Even V0 by U0 is also written as F0 minus V0 by F0 into D by FE. This is the magnification of the compound microscope when the image is obtained at infinity. And moreover, this F0 by F0 minus V0 by F0 is also written as L by F0. Why is it L by F0? F0 is very small only. So F0 minus V0, V0 is more. F0 minus V0 is almost is nothing but V0, which is L. Or you can observe here A, D, O. And A dash, B dash, F naught. These two are similar triangles. This one and this one are similar triangles. This is nothing but what? L. Okay. Then H dash or H1 from these two triangles. O is alpha. This is also alpha. Here it is what? F0. And this is what here? FE. H1. This is what? H. So what you know already? These two are similar triangles. H dash by H1 by H is equal to what you know? L by F0. Then H dash by H is equal to L by F0, which is nothing but magnification of the eigen. So that even magnification of the eigens also can be written as L by F0 into D by FE. So different expressions can be written as compulsory you should know that one L is equal to V0 plus UE or V0 plus FE only when the object is obtained at infinity, V0 plus FE. Otherwise you have to remember as V0 plus UE. I hope you understood. Once again, let me revise that. Here no need to get confusion. We need to observe the small objects so that the object should be a small focal length and eye should be a large focal length, and our position of the eye is in between. Total magnification is magnification of the object into magnification of the eye. M0 into M. Then M0 is nothing but magnification of the object to image of the object to the object distance of the object is magnification of the object. Whereas magnification of the eyelens is similar, already have done D by UE. Then final expression is V0 by U0 into D by FU. This is what general expression for any position. General expression for any position for magnifying power of the compound microscope. Now let me explain based on this. Let me explain. The image at a near point, for a near point. And it may be same. This is what general expression for the magnifying power of the compound microscope. So that what we can write here, these remaining all the expressions are remaining same. This is also same, M is equal to L by F0 into D by FE. But what will be happening? What will the length of the microscope, how it will be changes? How it will be changes? Let me show that. This is also not V0 by U0 into D by FE. And this is also not D by FE. Okay, Here when you get, let me draw the shape, here it is the main shape. Now we should get the image at a near point. Yeah, this is what light wave which is passing through the optical center does not decay, and the light wave which is passing through the focus, it does not, it passes the band of the principal axis, passes through the focus point. What is this? AB, A dash, B dash. Now tell me, where we get the image at near point? The position of the image of the object to, it should be within the focus point of the image. Focus point of the image means here it is F naught, and this is what V naught. Now the focal length of the object to I lens. This is what I lens. This is object to. This is what I lens. The focal length of the lens is what here F E. Now the object is in between optical center and focus length, focus point of the lens. Then where to get the image? On the same side, inverted and magnified. Is it? And highly magnified. That is what. Now let me take here one light ray, which is here FE, and one more light ray passing this one, and one more light ray. Here FE is also FE. Are these two light rays intersecting? Not intersecting, but they would be diverging from the points, slightly diverging. Then how to get the image? When you produce them in backward direction, when they produce back direction, then you will get image. Is it? Now A double dash, B double dash, which is the final image. And this is nothing but D. Now, to an observer, what would be the position of the image? At near point. And this is what the actual size of the object. But what would be the size of the image? Highly magnified. Highly magnified. Then H2, let us take it. It is H, H1, and H2. Now, the position of the object from optical center is called distance in the number UE. Object distance. In this case, we cannot write L is equal to V naught plus FE, but V naught plus UE. Compulsory, we have to mention that L is equal to V naught plus UE. Whenever the image is obtained at infinity, then only object distance is equal to the focal length of the lens. Object distance of the lens is equal to the focal length of the lens, so that we have it in L is equal to V naught plus UE. Or wherever L by F naught into D by UE. This is also one of the expression. Let us already have shown here by taking H by F naught is equal to L by V naught. L by F naught. Then V naught is equal to L by F naught. Now magnification of the object is L by F naught. Then D by UE we need to find magnification of the image. That means what is the final image of the compound microscope? VE, which is nothing but image distance of the eye lens, is equal to what? Minus D. Then 1 by VE minus 1 by UE is equal to 1 by FE. From this one, what you can write here? This is what expression? 1 by minus D minus of minus UE is equal to 1 by FE. Then what we can write here? 1 by UE is equal to 1 by D plus 1 by FE. 1 by D plus 1 by FE. Now this one you substitute in this expression, on this expression, m is equal to v naught by u naught into d into 1 by u in 1 by d plus 1 by f in. That difference is equal to l by r v naught by u naught into 1 plus d by f e is a magnifying power of the compound matrix. Or even you can write m is equal to l by f naught into 1 plus d by f e. Let us see an example. Focal length of the objective is focal length of objective is 2 cm. 2 cm. Whereas focal length of the eyelens is of eyelens FE, this is what F naught is equal to 20 cm. See that? Objective is having less focal length, eyelens is having more focal length. Then what will be the magnifying power of the compound microscope when the object is formed at a near point and the object is formed at a far? Then what you can make here? M is equal to for near point, m is equal to what again? L by F naught into D by FE, and length of the microscope is given 15 cm. Now let me write here, L is what? 15 by 2 into D, 25 by 20. D is near point 25 cm. And F is 220, F is equal. Then 5, 5 and 4, 5. That is equal to, then what you get here? 15, 75 by 8. That is equal to 9.37 is a magnifying power of the microscope for near point. But for infinity, for far point. This is what for far point. For near point, L by F naught into 1 plus D by FE. For far point, we have done, which is L by F naught into D by FE. For near point, m is equal to l by f naught into 1 plus d by f. Then 15 by 2 into 1 plus 25 by 20 we have taken. Then 7.5 into 1 plus 5 by 4. 5 by 4, 7.5 into 9 by 4, is it? Then 1.358375. Then again 9 into 1.875. 16.875. Yes, 16.875 is the magnification for microscope, for compound microscope, when the object is at near point. Remember, so you can observe clearly that whenever the image is formed at 4 point or infinity, the magnifying power is 9.37. But whenever the image is formed at near point, the magnification is 16.875. So the magnification is more in case of near point. But the thing is, when the image is formed at near point, the magnification is more, but it's not comfortable for viewing. But whereas the image is formed at a near point of infinity or far point, the magnification size is less, but it is comfortable for viewing. So that we have seen that the formation of the images for convex lens, that is what formation of the image for simple microscope and compound microscopes, what would be the magnification of this simple microscope and compound microscope. So whenever you want to get the image at near point and far point, in what cases the magnification is maximum? For near point is the magnification maximum, and for far point the magnification is minimum. But for this is what comfortable for the observer for the image. So that is what we have. The magnification of the compound microscope is greater than that of the simple microscope. Let us discuss with the example how to calculate the magnifications or the portion of the object depending upon this compound microscope. A compound microscope consists of a object to a focal length 2 cm. That is what here we have to see, that what would be the focal length of object 2. Focal length of object 2 f naught is equal to 2 cm given. Whereas eyepiece of focal length 6.25 cm. Focal length of eyepiece. FE is equal to 6.25 cm. Subtracted by a distance of 15 cm, that is what the length of microscope. Distance between that L is equal to what is it? 15 cm. How much then object be placed from the object 2 in order to obtain the final image at near point? Here we have taken object 2, and this is here eye lens, object 2. Here what should be the position of the object 2 we need to get an image at near point. Image at near point. Let me take here. If you want to get the image at near point, what should be the position of the final image at infinity? Sorry, final image at near point. Then what should be the position of the object here, which is less than the focal length? That means what is image distance? Image distance of eye lens is what here VE is equal to -25 cm. Whereas FE is equal to, you know already it is FE is 6.25 cm. Now what would be the position of the object 2? Then if you know object 2, you can get the Wiener curve. 1 by VE minus 1 by UE is equal to 1 by FE. Is it? Then what you can get here? 1 by UE is equal to 1 by UE FE minus 1 by VE minus 1. See that here, 1 by VE, V represents what? -25 minus 1 by FE, that is 6.25 centimeter. Is it? Fe is 6.25 centimeter. Then let us take here 25. What do you get here? -1 - 4 you will get here. That is equal to -5/25 is equal to -1/5. -1/5, 1/2e. Therefore, ue is equal to -5 centimeter. That is here the object distance is what? -5. Negative sign represents that here 5 centimeter. Now, can you tell what will be the object distance? Image distance of the object to totally 15 centimeter. Totally is 15 centimeter. Then we know UE is equal to 5 cm, then what is the image distance of object to 10 cm? Therefore, V0 plus UE is equal to 15, then V0 is equal to what again? 15 - 5, 10 cm. Yeah, negative sign is not take here. If you take negative sign, you will get 20, but which is not possible. Negative sign represents only the sign convention. Distance of the object is negative. But we need to calculate u0 value for each case. What is u0? Object distance. Where should be an object be placed in front of the object 2? Again, one for object 2. For object 2, 1/v0 - 1/u0 is equal to 1/f0. From this one, we substitute the 1/u0 is equal to 1/v0 - 1/f0. Substitute v0 value. Is it positive or negative v0? Positive only. Therefore, that is equal to 1/u0 is equal to 1/u0 is equal to 1/v0 is 10 minus 1/f0 is 2. That is equal to what is 10 here? 1 - 5. Then 1/u0 is equal to -4/10. U0 is equal to -10/4. -10/4. -10/4. Is it? Then -2.5 centimeter. Then the object should be placed at a distance 2.5 centimeter. This distance must be 2.5 centimeter to get the image at the A. Let us discuss the same thing for the object position to get the image at infinity. Image at infinity, that means what? VE is equal to infinity. VA is equal to infinity means what should be the object distance? If you want to get the image at infinity, what should be the distance of the object for eye length, UE value? It must be equal to focal length of the eye length. Then UE must be equal to FE, which is equal to 6.25 centimeter. That means here in this case UE is equal to FE 6.25 centimeter. Then what is the UE value? FE 6.25. Now take that, what is V0 value? V0 value is what? 8.75 centimeter. Therefore V0 plus FE is equal to 15. That implies V0 is equal to 8.75. 15 - 6.25. V0 is equal to 15 - 6.25. That is equal to 8.75 centimeters. object, image distance of object. But we need to calculate what? Object distance of the object. Where should be an object be placed in front of the object? Again, from 1 by V naught minus 1 by U naught is equal to 1 by F naught. Therefore, what you can write? 1 by U naught is equal to 1 by V naught minus 1 by F naught. 1 by V naught square is nothing but what? 8.75 minus F naught is equal to 2. Therefore, 1 by U naught is equal to what is this? 8.75 into 2. 2 minus 8.75 by 17.50. Then 2 minus 8.75, which is nothing but minus 6.75 by 17.50. This is minus negative sign. Now U naught is equal to minus 17.50 by 6.75 is equal to minus 7. We have taken 2 point, that means 3 6 18, approximately 3, which is 2.59 centimeter is the position of the object to, for the position of the object from the object. This is what, why we have to not consider L is equal to always L by F naught. Always L is nothing but what we have to know, V naught plus UE. V naught plus UE, that is the position of the object from to get near point image, for to get image into far point. VE is equal to infinity far point. So this is what here we have discussed today about the, what do you mean by the optical instruments? Simple microscope and compound microscope. How to get the magnification of the simple microscope for near point and far point. How to get the magnification for compound microscope at near point and far point. So that in next class we can see that the telescopes. What would be the difference to the microscopes and the telescopes? The purpose of using microscope is to observe the magnifying size of the object to get the magnification. The purpose of using telescope are you have needed the binoculars to observe the distant object closer to our eye, but not to magnify. So these things we will discuss in the next class, and keep practice on these topics of the simple microscope and compound microscope. The ray diagrams, formation of images for compound microscope and simple microscope, and not only that, magnifying power calculation. For board exams they are asking the formulas, mostly what is the magnifying power of the simple microscope, compound microscope, for near point and far point. And the diagrams also asking what would be the formation of images for simple microscope and compound microscope. Thank you. Thank you.